Rufus tracking is basically locating different entities, the thing that you saw in the first video where we augmented Harvey and UAV is basically using brute force tracking. So brute force tracking is usually working inside, outside your image. It's using mainly GPS, an orientation sensor, which does not work inside building most of the time. And so we had to come up with a better solution to track inside building. Needed to find a solution that was accurate to within 3 meters, because that's basically what gives you the resolution that you need to know if you are in this room or in this room. This was provided by the Worcester Polytechnic Institute, who has done several testing experiments for firefighters. They actually were losing several people in that fire, this image. And so I think as a consequence, they created a test and invited the industry to come and do this test. So they gave this requirement. So the idea was to piggyback on this brute force tracking. So the company, ITT, had also produced a military radio using QMFR, and I will not know what it is anymore, for the acronym, quite a lot of something like that. But basically, it's using ultra-wideband. I don't know if some of you know ultra-wideband, but basically it's a kind of Wi-Fi that uses a much broader spectrum. Instead of transmitting on one frequency, you transmit on many, many different frequencies. What does that allow you to do is to penetrate many more structures than only one frequency. You have usually a problem of penetration of structure with wave when trying to get Wi-Fi, GPS, or other kind of signal. There's always penetration problem with different material that can prevent the penetration. There's Faraday cage, so on and so forth. So this is kind of to alleviate with this problem. Ultra-wideband was able to penetrate the world much better. And then basically it's like a GPS system, where you use different fixed or non-position constellation. Here you have different radios that are put outside of the building. They are equipped with a GPS, so they know where they are. And then from that, you do time of flight ranging between different radios. The time of flight is basically you send a signal, you wait, the signal comes back, and you measure the time. There's different variation of that, but basically the same principles as GPS. GPS is sending us a signal, we receive it on the Earth, a very precise clock synchronization, so we know the time. From the time and the speed of light, we can basically find the distance. Same principle. So this was kind of a GPS indoor system, and we use fixed reference, those radio mounted on tripod. We could use those radio as the radio of the firefighter around the building, or on the fire truck as well. You don't necessarily need to put it on a tripod. So by putting 4 or 5 radio minimum around, we were able to locate at least close to the edge of the building. But inside the building, really inside, or in the elevators, or in some stair, we might have still some problems. So this was not the only solution that we used.